Sex workers have a rich, compelling, and complex relationship with their vaginas. This particular woman blows my mind. She was a sex worker, but she only did sex work with women. Las servidoras sexuales tienen relaciones profundas, irresistibles y complejas con sus vaginas. Esta mujer en particular me llamó mucho la atención. Era una servidora sexual, pero solo servía sexo a otras mujeres.
I love vaginas. I love women. I do not see them as separate things. Women pay me to dominate them, to excite them, to make them come. Did not start that way, though. No. On the contrary. I started out as a lawyer. Then, in my mid-20s, I became obsessed with making women happy. It began as a mission of sorts. Then I got involved in it. I got really good at it. Kind of brilliant. It was mild. So I started getting paid for it. It was as if I had found my calling. I wear outrageous outfits while I dominate women. Lace and silk and leather. And I use props. Whips. Handcuffs. Dildos. Oh, there was nothing like that in tax law. There was no props, no excitement. And I always hated those corporate suits that I wear now from time to time for my new line of work, and they have served quite nicely. But there was nothing like that in tax law. There was no wetness, no mysterious foreplay, no erect nipples, no delicious mouths. But more importantly, there was no moaning. Not the moaning that I'm talking about, at least. I see now. Moans were the thing that ultimately seduced me and got me addicted to making women happy. You see, when I was a little girl, I would see women in movies making love, making big orgasmic moaning noises. And I got straight to hysterical. I used to laugh. I couldn't believe that those big ungoverned, outrageous sounds would come out of women. And so I longed to moan. I would practice in front of the mirror. I would tape record it in various keys and tones. And whenever I played it back, it sounded fake. Well, it was fake. It wasn't rooted in anything sexual, really. Only in my desire to be sexual. And then, when I was 10 years old, I once had to pee really bad. It was in a car trip, and it went on for an hour. And by the time I got to this dirty little gas station, it was so exciting, I moaned. I moaned as I pee. I couldn't believe it. Me moaning in this dirty little gas station in what? Ciudad Colón? So I realized then that moans were connected to not getting what you want right away. And I realized that moans were better when they caught you by surprise. And that they came from this place, this mysterious place inside of you that was speaking its own language. I realized that moans were in fact that language. And so I became a moaner. It made most men anxious, frankly, it drove them crazy. I was too loud and they couldn't focus on what they were doing. And then they would lose focus and they would lose everything. So I couldn't make love in people's homes because the walls were too thin. I even got a reputation in my building. People would stare at me with contempt in the elevator, like, the noisy girl, that's me. I'm sorry. So men thought I was too intense. One of them even called me crazy. So I began to feel bad about my moan. And I became quiet and kind of like polite. I made noise into a pillow. I started to get headaches and stress-related disorders. And I was becoming hopeless. Until I discovered women. I discovered that most women loved my moaning. But more importantly, I discovered how deeply excited I would get when other women moaned. When I was responsible for other women moaning. So I made love to quiet women. And I found a place inside of them that shocked the moaning. And I made love to moaners. We found kind of like a deeper, I don't know, like a more penetrating kind of moan. So it was kind of like a surgery, like a delicate science to find the tempo, the exact location, or home of the moan, as I would call it. Sometimes I found it over women's jeans. Sometimes it was completely off the record, quietly disarming the surrounding alarms and moving in. Sometimes I used force, but not like violent or oppressing force. It was more like dominating, like, I'm going to take a second, so lay back and relax and enjoy the ride, kind of force. And of course I used props, and sometimes it was simply mundane. I found the moan even before things started. Just eating salad or chicken, just casual right there with my fingers, and balsamic vinegar spilled all over. And sometimes I made the woman find her own moan in front of me. I just snuck it out and waited for her to open herself. I wasn't fooled by any minor, more obvious moans. No. I pushed her all the way to find her power moan. So, throughout the years, I made a list of particular moans that I found, and I would like to share that list with you, if you don't mind. So, there's the clit moan. Ah! There's the vaginal moan. Ah! There's the combo clit vaginal moan. Ah! There's the almost moan. Ah! Ah! There's the ride on it moan. Ah! The elegant moan. Ah! The Jewish moan.
No, no.
The Catholic Latin American moan.
Madre Santissima.
There's the mountaintop moan.
Yole.
There's the uninhibited militant bisexual moan. There is the UPSer moan.